safety standards clearly state that pressure-reducing regulators shall be used only for the gas and pressures for which they are labeled. Because different gases have different volume and pressure requirements, manufacturers engineer regulators for specific gases. For instance, Victor edge regulators are color-coded and labeled for easy identification. Green for oxygen, red for acetylene, orange for LP gases, such as propane and propylene, gray for carbon dioxide, black for inert gases, such as argon and nitrogen, and yellow for air. Before we get into the procedure for installing regulators and hoses, remember this critical fact. Pure oxygen can reduce the kindling temperature of petroleum-based lubricants to room temperature, leading to violent combustion. Because of this, never lubricate any component of an oxy-fuel system. If you encounter oil or grease, stop. Call your welding supply distributor or other qualified service personnel and have them inspect and clean the parts.
Your first safety check is to be sure that all the valves, threads, and seats are free of oil and dirt. Inspect the fittings, making sure they're not dinged up or damaged in any way. We'll do this on both the cylinders and the regulators. Now on the regulator, if the nut on this regulator does not match the fitting on the cylinder, it means you've got the wrong regulator. You need to find the correct one because you never want to change the fittings on a regulator.
Before we attach these regulators, there's one good safety process I want you to follow for sure. Always stand to the side of the cylinder and clear the front of them. What we're going to do is crack this just a little bit and close her back off. But what has happened is I've cleared this valve assembly of all combustibles or any contaminants. I'll do the same for the fuel gas and shut her back off. Now we're ready to attach the regulators.
As we install the regulators, be sure to use the right tool. An open-ended wrench, a crescent wrench will work as well. But never use a pliers or a pipe wrench. Always use the right tool for the job.
Now we're ready to install the hose. Keep in mind that there's three grades of hose available. There's an R grade and an RM grade. Those are used for acetylene. There's also a T grade, which is used for any fuel gas, and is the only grade that's allowable for alternate fuel. Take a look at the hose and inspect it. You'll notice that the nuts on this are a little bit different. The acetylene hose, which is typically red, will have a groove across the nut, which indicates left-hand threads. The oxygen hose, which is typically green, will not have that groove because it's a right-hand thread. And inspect the hose. Make sure there's no oil and grease, as always, and give it a good check to make sure there's no cracks anywhere in the system. If you find cracks or you find some oil or grease or you see some damage in the hose, change it. Do not use the hose. Now it's time to attach the hose.
Gas hoses need purging to remove any potential contaminants that could have entered the system during manufacturing, since the last time they were used, or during prolonged storage. This contamination, if not removed, could be forced into your equipment and potentially cause clogging, failure, or provide a source of combustion. However, before you can purge the hose, first open the gas cylinders using these specific techniques.
We'll first start with the oxygen. One of the things to remember is make sure that the oxygen knob and the acetylene knob are backed out all the way. Then you want to make sure that you're standing with the oxygen valve between you and the regulator. Open it up slowly. Once it's stabilized, then you want to open it all the way. The oxygen cylinder valve is designed to seal in the fully open and the fully closed position. Now we'll repeat this with some differences on the acetylene. Again, stand to the side and open it slowly. Now we only want to open this about 3/4 to one full turn. And the only reason behind that is in case of an emergency downstream, I can get over here and shut this off quickly.
Now to purge a hose, turn in the adjusting knob to about 5 psi and allow it to flow for a few seconds. Depending on the length of the hose, that time may vary. Then back out the adjusting knob after you've allowed adequate flow and repeat the process for the other hose.
These safety basics are worth repeating. Never use a regulator or hose other than for its intended gas. Check with the current regulations if you have any questions. Get in the habit of inspecting all fittings and connections. Always, always ensure that they're free of oil, grease, and dirt. Slowly crack cylinder valves and allow pressure to stabilize before opening further. When opening a cylinder, be sure to stand on the side opposite the valve. Always purge cylinder valves and hoses to remove contaminants. Never open an acetylene valve more than one turn. Leave any tools needed to operate the valve in place, which will help with quick shutoff should you need it.